New York City, the city where the food options are just as diverse as the people. The city that cultivates action words like high energy, fast paced, and on the move. It's a super city with real life superheroes. One of those superheroes is Omega Psi Phi member DJ John Quick, who is the ultimate entertainment ambassador for the city, for a city where super dreams thrive. Grown and Greek TV got a chance to talk with DJ John Quick at the famous Red Rooster restaurant in Harlem. Check it out. And only DJ John Quick. Now, before we came up to New York City and Harlem, your name was mentioned. So to me, that means like you are like the man.
I'm not the man.
Well, no, nah. That's not a true statement.
Nah. I'm just trying to make it in life. That's all.
Well, I appreciate your modesty, but no, like your reputation precedes itself.
That's nice to know. Nice to know.
Now, any given day of the week, where can people find you? Can you run down the list?
Well, my week begins on the weekend. So Friday nights, I'm across the street here at Corner Social. I'm doing an event called Flashback Fridays. Saturdays, I'm right here at Red Rooster. I do Motown Mimosas, the Saturday Soul Brunch, from 12 to 5:30. And then Sundays, I'm at Cove Lounge. We do something called Blackout Sundays, which is basically we're supporting a black-owned venue. During football season, we didn't even watch football because we were supporting Colin Kaepernick. And, you know, it's just good music. You know, it's a variety of music. On Fridays, it's mostly, you know, throwbacks. Saturday, same thing, mostly like 80s R&B. And then Sunday is everything from Future to Jay-Z to Stevie Wonder. It's all over the place. So.
And you do your thing for all of them
on the
music. You curate the music.
Yes, I am the curator. I am the creator of the soundtrack. I do the score, all that.
All right. So you are also a member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
Yes, the illustrious Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated.
Where were you made?
Well, I was a grad student at Marshall University, so technically, you know, you have a grad chapter that's responsible for you, which is Xi Alpha. But of course, being on campus, I was made a new beta. So it's kind of cool, you know. I mean, technically, I guess it's both, but I got love for both chapters, you know what I'm saying? Like, big shout out to my LP, Daniel Jones, Xi Alpha. He is the KRS of the fraternity.
Okay.
You know, yeah, he's doing big things. And, you know, just big shout out to all the brothers at Marshall University. You know, we hold it down. You know, it's a small campus, but, you know, it's a saying in our fraternities, members versus men. It's about quality over quantity.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm Spring 89, Trey, you know. I was made when they were still being made, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
yeah, I was a tray in my line. I was a tail too. We had a small line still.
Okay.
So how is
Omega Life here in New York City?
Omega Life is good. There's thousands of brothers in the city. Like, I can't even keep up at the time.
Okay.
So, you know, it's all love, you know. We have an amazing boat ride over the summer. All of the metro chapters get together to do a huge boat ride, like over like 1,500 people on this boat. It's bananas.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It looks like one of those big cruise boats. It has like four floors. It's huge. And it's a great boat ride. We always have like a variety of DJs. You know, we have like a major musical guest. So that's the dopest thing about New York, the boat ride. Like, it's been historically that way. I remember one year they said, I was not even living up here, but they were saying Michael Jordan got on the boat or whatever.
Wow.
'Cause, you know, he's the bruh. So,
right.
You know, it was all good. So the Omega boat ride is, yeah. But there's a lot of graduate and intermediate and undergraduate chapters in the whole New York City area. So, like every time I'm DJing somewhere, someone will come up and introduce themselves as an Omega that I may not have even seen, you know. So it's all good.
You still set it out?
You know what?
No.
I have to really be moved. Like, I can still do it. Like, on a physical standpoint, I can still set out a hop, you know.
Okay.
But, you know, I have to be really moved. You know, I leave that to the younger bros. I'm Spring 89, you know. Leave that to the younger bros. You know, except maybe on my birthday, I might, you know.
You might do it.
This is something, you know, the anniversary, May 3rd, you know. But other than that, I try not to do too many explosive movements outside of the gym.
Right. How long have you been DJing?
Oh, wow. I've been DJing technically for over 30 years, but in terms of like really like taking it serious as a profession, probably since like 2005, I heard how much Biz was making. So big shout out to Biz, and through his manager, he was basically telling me like how much, you know, a roundabout park thinking. I said, oh, I need to take this more serious. And since 2005, I've just been building and building, and now I do about 250 gigs a year, and not just in New York. I do Essence every year. You know, I go to the islands. You know, I get overseas every once in a while as well. You know, it's just funny. I never would have thought something I learned as a 14-year-old would be my way of, you know, paying for, you know, my rent, mortgage, and stuff like that. You know, so it's really cool to do something that's kind of like second nature to you for a living.
Right. Now, do you consider John Quick a DJ, or do you consider John Quick a brand?
It's a brand.
It's a brand.
It's a brand. Because
now, what's the difference to you?
Well, DJ is just that. That's all you do is DJ. I do more than DJ. I always think everybody's a brand, whether they want to admit it or not. I consider myself a brand because I get a lot of brands coming at me wanting to partner up. So therefore, they're familiar with my brand, and they want to be associated with it. So the main thing is, when you're a brand, you got to act like it 24/7. You can't have any mess ups or anything like that, screw ups or whatever. And I'm very cognizant of my place here in the New York City community in terms of a DJ, in terms of someone who always tries to portray black men in a positive light. Like I try to represent for the culture.
Gotcha.
You know what I mean? And I do a Women's Month event every year, except this year it'll be actually in April technically, so that's not Women's Month, but I've been doing it for 9 years. I honor black women of color. Well, not just black women, just women of color who are kind of either on the come up in their industry or someone who's been there, been building bridges for people but never got that due. So my next one, my ninth one, will be April 7th. I call it DJ John Quick Some Heroines of Excellence Awards.
Wow.
So, you know, I've honored people from Beverly Bond to Michelle Carey from Al Jazeera, you know, of course, Deja Vu, who's a radio star on Sirius XM.
You know, Deja Vu started in Birmingham. Well, one of her stops was in Birmingham.
Yeah, that's what I was on the air with today. Deja Vu.
Really?
Yeah, I'll be on there with her Wednesday on WBLS 107.5.
Right.
New York City, you can hear us on iTunes and Next Radio and the TuneIn app.
Right.
But anyway, so yeah, I do the Mix of Six with her.
Okay.
On Monday and Wednesdays. It's sort of like a rotation of like DJs that I grew up on that are, you know, currently in the mix. So it's kind of humbling, and at the same time, it makes you feel good, like, okay, hey, Ma, I made it.
Indeed, man.
I'm from West Virginia. I'm not from New York.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm a country boy. I'm from a small town called Dunbar, 35,000 people right outside the Capitol. Yeah, but that's why I have so many connections. Like, I went to Marshall University.
Right.
And I grew up next to an HBCU, West Virginia State College. And technically, like, I know in 89, like, all the undergraduate lines and the graduate lines, we crossed on this campus of West Virginia State, you know, in terms of in our district or whatever.
Right.
So I grew up on that campus. So even though I went to Marshall, I always get home to West Virginia State College's homecoming because I pretty much know everybody that you know, went there or whatever.
Right.
My first gig was there as a 14-year-old. No, I was 15. I DJed at Delta Party.
Uh-huh.
But, so cool story about that. I couldn't drive, I wasn't old enough. So my mom used to take me down to the campus, I unload all my stuff. Like 9 o'clock, she goes, all right, I'll be back. At the time, the parties were ended at 2. She come back, pull up. It got to a point where all the kids on campus knew my mom. Because they said, oh, here comes the DJ's mom. She pulled up. Y'all move out the way.
Right.
Yeah. So I think that's funny. I think part of me doing the Women's Month event is kind of paying that forward to having the strong black women in my life who always supported me.
Right.
And yeah, so.
Well, I appreciate your time.
That's all good. You got me rolling.
It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to meet you.
That's a pleasure to meet you too.
Like you were one of the people that I was like, you gotta get with him. I appreciate the time.
No,
and you an Omega.
That's right.
And you a D9.
That's right.
It's even better,
D9 man. Love.
And I'm gonna check you out. I'm a fan now.
Yep.
I'm a fan.
So I'm a fan now too. And
yes.
I thank you for having this platform, you know, to give us a voice. That's very important.
Oh, yeah.
Important. Absolutely.